All right, joining me once again here on the Matthew Filipowicz Show is my friend, the Reverend Billy Talen. Reverend Billy is, of course, the pastor of the Church of Stop Shopping. He is the author of the book, The End of the World, all of which you can find at revbilly.com. You can also follow him on Twitter at RevBillyTalen. Reverend Billy, thank you so much for being on the show again.
Amen. It's good to be here. Amen.
All right, so Reverend Billy, actually, your current stage show with the Church of Stop Shopping is actually called Monsanto is the Devil. You recently traveled to St. Louis, Missouri, and went to Monsanto headquarters. Tell us all about your trip.
We went in a 50-seat bus, and I have to confess it wasn't a veggie-powered bus, amen. There's the sin. But to visit the world headquarters of Monsanto, we knew that we were going to this little township in North St. Louis that is next door to Ferguson. We'd already been to Ferguson once to get arrested on with the ministers, rabbis, imams, and all sorts of self-appointed religious figures on a clergy day called Moral Monday in late August. And we went there and got arrested together. So we'd already been there once. And this was our return to St. Louis. But the visit to the Devil's Front Lawn to have an organic Thanksgiving dinner there, that was an old, old plan. We had raised $25,000 on Indiegogo, you know, and we were working with the Organic Consumers Association and Stephanie Spear from EcoWatch. That was supported and planned. But then, of course, the murder of Michael Brown wasn't. And so we were going there we were getting our idea that human rights and earth rights have got to be one and the same thing someday, right? We were getting our own sermon and our own songs were coming back at us from reality. We were getting this white Ferguson Police Department from this slave state staring at us in one bus window. In the other bus window, we had the luxurious campus of the great poisoner, you know, the mad chemist who brought us PCBs and Agent Orange and neonicotinoid pesticides and GMO suicide seeds. So I know you asked me to talk about one and then the other, but it's coming out there simultaneous because it was simultaneous. And we were not ready for it. We wanted to back up and have one and then the other, but they came together, being killed by bullets and being killed by invisible toxins. We were meeting two devils at once. I take a breath and ask you for a question.
Absolutely. Again, I'm talking to my friend, the Reverend Billy Talen. So, I mean, the trip started, you know, and again, the search for justice is one. I mean, when there is injustice anywhere, it's everywhere. And so you were at Monsanto. And so tell us about that. What actually happened outside there? You actually did an organic Thanksgiving outside of the Monsanto headquarters. How did that go and how did Monsanto respond?
Well, we got a call from the Creve Corps, that's the little township next to Ferguson, where Monsanto has its world headquarters. Creve Corps, which it's an old French phrase. I think it means something like a broken heart. Creve Corps. And we got a call from these beautiful sounding policeman from Creve Coeur. And we said, speak to us in French, please. No, they were saying, well, for your safety, we want to talk to you about your trip that we know about, of course, and we have some guidelines for you. And our lawyer, Wiley Stecklow, came into the picture to negotiate with them. And we ended up on their front lawn, which we thought it would be flowing, you know, with green grasses, or at least an autumnal situation, but it was just snow and ice. And we had done our reconnaissance on our previous trip to St. Louis, and it was lovely that day.
Yeah.
But we were told we could not touch the logo on the front of the pink, which the treasured genitalia of Monsanto. We couldn't touch it. We could do a lot of, you know, we could pull faces and do power fists around it, but we couldn't touch it.
But don't dare touch it.
Hallelujah. So, okay. So these, we cooked our organic meal in a local homeless shelter that had stoves, and we, the Stop Shopping Choir has a wonderful number of cooks, and we marched with our food along the state highway from a neighboring park. You know, there it is, a civil rights image walking along the highway. And we set up our tables, and we sang and we preached and exorcised the logo to make it particularly powerless in this coming year as we hope the honeybees make a comeback against the neuropathic pesticides in the neonicotinoid class of pesticides developed by the Bayer company, a Nazi company. That the crop protection program of the Bayer company was started in the 50s by Fritz Vermeer, who was in jail for 7 years out of the Nuremberg trials, and who was there running a factory at Auschwitz. So, I mean, these are mean-ass companies. If anybody thought there was that evil became different, these are tough-ass companies. It's just that they're covered now with this Sunday school lesson-like marketing campaign. Mm-hmm. And Monsanto actually says they are trying to save the honeybee, even as the honeybee's population plummets. Even as the bees covered with pollen can't find their way back to the home hive because of the presence of Monsanto's profits on their wings and in their sophisticated navigation systems. No, the Monsanto runs something called the Bee Health Institute. And they invite honeybee activists to meet at their headquarters. You know, come here, meet here. You know, you can meet for free, and we'll surveil you or whatever. So we had a wonderful dinner there, and got gradually colder and colder, until we had to break up. But we had people coming in who drove all night from Denver and Omaha and Chicago. And, we had about 100 of us out there in the cold. An organic Thanksgiving dinner at the front gate of Monsanto. That was the nonviolent direct action of it.
Did anyone in the group touch the forbidden fruit of the Monsanto logo, or was the security there not allowing you to come close and actually touch the shining beacon?
Well, as the beleaguered pastor of this group of Randy, you know, that's kind of an old-fashioned word, isn't it? Randy.
Yeah.
oversexed, you know. my parishioners are in recovery from about 7 different fundamentalist religions, and it seems as if part of releasing yourself from the fundamentalism of your grandparents is to find your physical desires and express them and develop them. And I wouldn't be able to make an absolute assurance that the treasured genitalia of the Monsanto Corporation were not touched in some way by maybe one of the radical fairies, for instance, in our group. So the Sisters of Perpetual Indulgence, we have a sister in the bass section. So God knows what happened, really. But Wiley Steklo, our long-suffering pro bono lawyer, may have been looking the other way, and somebody may have reached out.